stuff, which is just added at the second brush. What's wonderful about the system, of course, is that there is no limit to what you can design on it. And it commands the synthesizer, which creates there's no limit to the amount of sound that you can put in. Not only can you have million different sounds, single sounds for each time that you hit a special spot, but you can also have a whole symphonic structure if you want, every time you hit the spot. There's absolutely no limit to the sequences that you can put into the system. And you can also create animation that goes beyond this particular pattern. There are two kinds of animation which I can show you on tape, but I don't have the program to be for both kinds. But one of them is, for instance, you can design a character who is pre-programmed to dance with you. So on a very large screen, as you appear and dance in front of the camera, you are stimulating a virtual dancer, in this case a skeleton, to actually accompany your dance. Now, it's not a mechanical accompaniment. There's sufficient randomization of that partner's, virtual partner's movement, that as you are dancing with the partner, you are actually seeing that character following you in different ways. And you can follow, you can generate different dances, different dance movements from your virtual partner. So that there you have a kind of interaction which is quite extraordinary. And again, there is no limit except in the memory of the system, that system. There is no limit to the amount of variation you can bring to any kind of movement on the screen. The other type of movement is contained in one of the functions of the computer, which is a strange, I don't know how it works, why it works that way, but it does. You will have a bird, let's say, that will be flying into the screen, and if your hand touches the bird, or if the image of your hand touches the bird, it turns into something else and follows your body. And you can sort of, you know, play with it, and then you kick it away, and as you kick it away, it leaves your foot and becomes a bird again. Yeah. So that's another kind of movement. It's called a left hold and right hold position. I will show you the detail of the program later. Meanwhile, I'm just going to demonstrate what it can do. What I wanted to show you first with this is playing the drums using the digitizer. Now, if I had a good backdrop, my finger would appear precisely instead of my whole, you know. The effect comes from that my whole body is in there. If I had a good backdrop, which I can't because of the setup as it is, you'd be able to control exactly where your image would hit every point and therefore create that interactive situation. Now you have you have noise. You have video noise in the background, which means that this is going to be activated all the time. I'll just show you another example of what we have done. This is a bat. Now, it's difficult to play that thing, but you can change keys there with one hand. And the people who can play bats play this very well. I can't.
What's the background there?
The background is awful. It's the remnant of the 60s. I shouldn't be mean because I have to say that I like very much the artist better, but he has a taste for that. That's his thing. Okay. let's see. I'll show you another one. Well, actually, now that I've said mean things about good old Vincent, I can show you my own work, which is bad. that's the stuff that I created to put around with it. Now, and now the... Now, the interesting part about this is that you can pre-record. You can pre-record a sound structure which will be repetitive. I've just had three notes, but you can have as many as you want, and then use it as a base for a melody, let's say, and then play your melody on that base. My melody is not very good enough. And of course you have colorization, which means you have changes. Okay. let me bring you another one. One of my favorites is this one, the harp. Yeah, see why. It really is a lovely idea. Now, I'll show you what I'm going to do now. You see that little arrow there, if you can see it, if you can't, here it is. It's a little arrow that changes the program automatically so that when the artist is performing what he does, he raises his hand, touches the arrow, and he moves on to the next program. You see how flexible that is, which for a performance is very, it's very convenient. But always when I'm in a situation like this, I get into the arrow, and in the middle of describing one program, instantly I get into the other one. So what I do is I call the icon, and I circle it by touching it. So you can work, you can actually write onto the screen. You can write your program and see what happens as you write it, which is a brilliant possibility. And so I've just circled this arrow and I say delete and goodbye the arrow. So now I can safely run the system using the digitizer. Now somebody's head, who's that? Something happened right there. You can just move and play yourself. Now that harp was played, it was in Toronto, and somebody in New York played the harp, and it was quite evident. And then the guy who was in charge of the transportation of the signal from video conferencing room to the other was in Atlanta at US Sprint. And he was checking on whether the signal was working, and he saw us doing that, and he said, "What are you guys doing? Isn't that wonderful?" And we said, "Well, sure, if you want to play with that, do it too." So he came on to the system, and we saw him in on our screen, because he had direct access, and he began to play with it. And so he had people from New York and Atlanta playing at once with a program in Toronto. That's very... Yeah. I'll show you some of that if I have to take. What else? Oh, that's good too. That's an interesting one because it has different levels of colorization. First I run up. Then I have different speed of cycling. So I've got this speed with going through that cycle. Then I have this one, and you'll see also. And then this one. But if the mouse is not interesting, if I do it with a digitizer, you'll see what happens. Too bad we don't have more definition. Which means that I don't have enough control of the image itself. But see, I have a stroboscopic effect that is a time image coming from there and a continuous event coming from there, which means that these are only several functions, but I can control a whole sequence of interactive games with this program by making all these dots sensitive to different speeds and different rhythms of color changes, from cycling, and image reproduction. My own image will be treated by the system as well. So.